Hello and welcome to News Pulse, your primetime English news bulletin. I'm Esther. These are the headlines. Deputy Chief Minister Y. Patton today informed that the September 7 order on shifting some branches and cells from the present Deputy Commissioner's office to new complex Chumugadima has been revoked. He also informed that the Sub-Treasury office will function at the new complex as independent branch. The Congress Party on Monday staged a nationwide silent protest over Lakhimpur Kheri violence and demanded the dismissal of Ajay Mishra from the post of Union Minister of State for Home Affairs. Five Army personnel, including a junior commissioned officer, were martyred in action during a counter-terrorist operation in Jammu and Kashmir's Rajouri sector in the Pir Panjal Ranges. An encounter broke out between security forces and terrorists during an anti-insurgency operation in Poonch district. BJP leader and Minister of Transport in the Uttarakhand government, Yashpal Arya, on Monday joined the Congress party ahead of the assembly polls. Now for the news and details. The largest limestone cave in Mimi area of Kifre district, measuring 200 feet in length and 150 feet in height, consisting of several chambers and rocks and cliffs, which was once owned by the Boomer clan of the Mimi village, is now owned by 8 villages. The uniqueness of the cave is that at the cliff of the rock, there are 3 limestone caves, also known as the bat caves, as thousands of bats roost there. Every year, after the fall of the local festival Puthangzu by the Yimkyung community, the bat harvest begins in the second week of October every year. Harvesting each cave one after the other, lasting for 5 to 6 days in the main cave and extending another 2 to 3 days for another cave. The bat harvesting has got some certain traditional regulations, where every male folk in the Boomer clan must get his share of bats from his birth till death. The harvest has been practiced for generations. During the first and second day of the harvest, every male folk from the Boomer clan will get his share of the harvested bats, while on the third day, the harvested share of the bat will be availed only for the household of the clan. Before the arrival of Christianity in the region, several rituals and rites have been performed for the harvest. For instance, releasing of bats alive with the belief of it to be the guardian of the cave. While some practices can still witness till today, where a bat is being placed in the palm when a male from the Boomer clan dies, with the belief that their ancestors from the spiritual realms will recognize the deceased as a member of the clan. Makezo on the telephone with us, whose family has been following this age-old tradition for generations after generations. Hi Makezo, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, hi. So tell us about this ritual. How long has your family been practicing this bat harvesting festival?
So far as our findings, we cannot assure since when it started. Still then, we believe, and since time immemorial, it's okay. Practicing.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, has your family practiced this festival this year?
Yeah, yes. We are doing it.
Okay. So, in approximately how many bats would you say are present in these caves during this time?
During this time, hopefully, as today's harvest, it could be more than 10,000. That's what we are expecting.
Okay, 10,000. All right. Okay,
yeah.
And so during this harvesting, there's a bat eating festival as well. Am I correct?
Yeah.
So when you're eating this, is it in the caves that the feast is being done, or you take it back to the village and then the Boomer clan has a whole feast happening?
No, see, Phutang is already over by 6th of October.
Okay.
And then following days, of course, since if Sundays are there, then we shifted another leg on Monday or Tuesday only. Follow this, we used to get down to the bed scarf and then we harvest it. And then we celebrate, yeah.
Okay. Is the Boomer clan or your family aware about, you know, since we have now about the COVID and all that, it has come from bats. Is the Boomer clan aware of this, that it can cause certain diseases? Or the claims of certain diseases that it can cause? What about your clan and then your village in particular? What do you feel about this?
No, we don't think that it spreads the viruses or this and that, diseases and all that.
Mm-hmm.
Because since time immemorial, we are practicing every annually. Annually, we are practicing, we are doing it.
Okay. According to reports, some few years ago, I think researchers came to study your clan, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay.
Yes. So are you aware of this?
Exactly.
Okay, so it did happen. Some researchers from abroad, foreign researchers, they came and they wanted to study this bat eating festival. Is that correct?
Yeah, yes, they came and they study. Oh. But then we didn't get any proper confirmation yet. We were told that they will come again.
Okay, which year was this, may I ask?
It was in 2015, 16 and 17.
Okay, what exactly did these researchers do? I'm told that they were American, and then from Wuhan also some researchers came.
No.
Okay, not from
Wuhan. We didn't get any information who came from Wuhan.
Okay. So yeah. What did they do, these researchers, when they came to Mimi village or Kifre?
They were trying to find out if there's any viruses or diseases can be found from bears or something like that. That's what they came and then they approached us.
Okay, they approached your clan, and then did they take any samples from the clan apart from taking samples of the bats there?
Yeah, they have taken, but then it's not, we didn't get yet any proper confirmation yet regarding the diseases and all.
Okay, so they did take your samples, you're saying, these researchers. Do you have any idea who permitted these researchers to come into the village and do this research? Is there any claims or any 100% possibility that maybe the government or whoever, is there any claim on this?
Yes, these research fellows, they came and they asked and then they were permitted.
Okay, they had got permit to do this research on the clan.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much, Makezo.
Thank you.
In other news, the Congress Party on Monday staged a nationwide silent protest over Lakhimpur Kheri violence and demanded the dismissal of Ajay Mishra from the post of Union Minister of State for Home Affairs. Delhi Congress held a silent protest at Jantar Mantar over the Lakhimpur Kheri incident in solidarity with farmers. Jammu and Kashmir Congress in charge Rajani Patel and Congress President Ghulam Ahmed Mir along with other party leaders and members held a silent protest near the governor's house. Members of civil society organizations and Nagaland state government officials met with the Chumukedema police complex in Dimapur on October 11 to discuss matters related to the government's move to shift the Dimapur Deputy Commissioner's office to Chumukedema. The meeting was a closed-door event, but Deputy Chief Minister Yantungo Patton briefed media persons after the meeting. He said that the order on September 7 to shift some of the branches of the administration to the new Deputy Commissioner's complex in Chumukedema has been revoked. Among those who were in attendance in the meeting included Patton Home Commissioner Abhijit Sinha, Power Department Advisor Tovi Otoayemi, and Sericulture, Excise and Minority Affairs Advisor Zalio Rio, besides members of community organizations.
It was a fruitful discussion. Both the parties have agreed and will have assured the CSO that we will revoke that 7th September notification. For this sub-treasurer of his, it'll be a new creation only. Yeah, for other boosting, we're going to discuss in the cabinet. But for shifting of DC, it is put on hold, and there is no such order for shifting of DC office Dimapur to Chimikidima. We're going to boost one ATC there, not even if it is not DC. We will put under Sidikema EC and we'll have one ATC in Chimu.
Whatever ultimatum was submitted by them earlier, the core committee reiterated those points, and we had a detailed discussion on all the points that were raised. And it was decided that 7th September 2021, those instructions were conveyed to DC, that will be cancelled. And regarding other things, like shifting of the DC complex to this one, actually there is no order as such to shift. So there is nothing, there is no need for issuing an order for that. And the third one, which we are saying that that use of the tag, so that also is something which has been there for a long time, that use of the tag. But regarding whether there's an order or not for that, so that we are going to check, and on that we will revert. But the 7th September order we are going to revoke by today itself.
Bus services were affected in Mumbai and neighboring areas on Monday, and most of the shops and commercial establishments remain closed in the wake of the bun called across Maharashtra by three partners in the Maha Vikas Aghadi government to protest the killing of four farmers in Uttar Pradesh's Lakhimpur Kheri district. Several trade organizations in Pune have expressed support for Monday's Maharashtra bund. Meanwhile, demanding the Minister of State for Home, Ajay Mishra, be sacked and arrested in the Lakhimpur Kheri violence case, the Samyukt Kisan Morcha has warned the centre and the Uttar Pradesh government of phase-wise protests if the demands are not met by October 11th. Ashish Mishra, who was arrested late on Saturday, was remanded to judicial custody for 14 days and placed under COVID quarantine in the district jail in Lakhimpur Kheri. The violence in Lakhimpur has resulted in the death of eight people who the farmers said were allegedly knocked down by a vehicle carrying BJP workers.
हमारा आंदोलन शांति के मार्ग से ही होगा जिस तरह से वो किसानों की आवाज कुचली गई है और वो किसानों को मारा गया वो निंदाजनक है और उसके खिलाफ हम पूरी ताकत से जब तक उनको न्याय नहीं मिलता लड़ते रहेंगे
जो लोग आंदोलन में शामिल नहीं है जो लोग महाविकास आघाड़ी के नहीं है वो लोग ये आंदोलन को बदलाव करने बदनाम करने के लिए ये पथराव कर रहे हैं किसानों के समर्थन में यहाँ पे खड़े हुए हैं किसानों के ऊपर यदि कोई एट्रोसिटी या कोई बाधा लाने अत्याचार कर रहा होगा तो हम लोग नहीं सहन करेंगे संविधान को तोड़ने की यदि बात है और असंवैधानिक बर्ताव की यदि बात है तो हम रास्ते पे उतरेंगे
ऐसा कि जो लखीमपुर में हुआ है वो तो दुर्दैवी है क्रूर भी है ऐसा कि किसान जो शांततापूर्ण मार्ग से वहां का आंदोलन कर रहे थे उन पर गाड़ी डाल के कुचलना उनको मारना ये बहुत क्रूर घटना है उसका निषेध हम सब कर रहे हैं
Five army personnel, including a junior commissioned officer, were martyred in action during a counter-terrorist operation in Jammu and Kashmir's Rajouri sector in the Pir Panjal ranges. An encounter broke out between security forces and terrorists during an anti-insurgency operation in Poonch district. The operation was launched in a village close to DKG in Surankote in the early hours following intelligence inputs about the presence of terrorists there. The encounter was going on when the last reports were received. The hiding ultras opened heavy fire on the search parties, resulting in critical injuries to a JCO and four other ranks, according to a Defence Ministry spokesperson. They were shifted to a hospital for treatment where they succumbed to their injuries. Officials said there are reports about the presence of a group of heavily armed terrorists in the Chamrer forest. After they managed to sneak from across the line of control, security forces earlier killed a terrorist in the Hajin area of Bandipora district. He was affiliated with the proscribed terror outfit Lashkar-e-Taiba and was involved in the recent killing of a civilian in the Bandipora area. Senior BJP leader and Minister of Transport in the Uttarakhand government, Yashpal Arya, on Monday joined the Congress party ahead of the assembly polls. His son, Sanjeev, also joined the grand old party in the presence of former Chief Minister Harish Rawat and All India Congress Committee General Secretary K.C. Venugopal in Delhi. Uttarakhand will go to the polls early next year. Welcoming Yashpal to the party fold, Venugopal said that this is one of the happiest moments for the party as Uttarakhand is going to have an election. Today, Yashpal Arya ji and Sanjeev Arya ji with us in this press conference. This gives a clear indication of the election in Uttarakhand, he said.
आज देखिए बड़ी खुशी की बात है कि कांग्रेस संस्कृति में और कांग्रेस के विचारधारा को जिन्होंने आगे बढ़ाया और कांग्रेस संस्कृति को हमेशा बढ़ाने का काम किया है, यशपाल आर्य जी ने आज कांग्रेस परिवार में फिर से वापसी करी है। और इससे ये स्पष्ट हो चुका है कि उत्तराखंड राज्य के अंदर जो भारतीय जनता पार्टी हाउसफुल का बोर्ड लगा के घूम रही थी, वो भी एक सीधा ढोकला साबित हुआ है, क्योंकि वो जो ढकोसला बार बार करती रही है, बेरोजगारी दूर करने का, भ्रष्टाचार को दूर करने का, महिला सशक्तिकरण का, पर्यावरण को ठीक करने का, आज इससे स्पष्ट हो गया कि वो हाउसफुल का बोर्ड भी सिर्फ दिखावा है और अंदर सब खाली है। और आने वाले दिनों में भारतीय जनता पार्टी को उत्तराखंड की जनता बाहर का रास्ता दिखाना तय कर दिया है।
कांग्रेस में दोनों बाप बेटे पिता पुत्र दोनों कांग्रेस में ज्वाइन किया, कांग्रेस को ताकत मिली और बीजेपी कह रही थी हाउसफुल का बोर्ड है वो सब झूठा ड्रामा नाटक है, बीजेपी की तरफ से लोग खिसकने लग गए, क्योंकि भविष्य बीजेपी में किसी का नहीं, ना प्रदेश का, ना देश का, ना जनता का, ना किसान मजदूर सब पीड़ित है, महंगाई चरम सीमा, बेरोजगारी चरम सीमा पर है, जनता हताश परेशान है, बहुत हताश निराश है। तो यशवराज जी ऐसे समय कांग्रेस आए, निश्चित हम उनका आभार व्यक्त करते हैं, उनको कांग्रेस में स्वागत भी करते हैं, लोगों में जोश है, पूरे प्रदेश में एक जुनून और खुशी की लहर कांग्रेस जनों में है। ये तो बहुत बड़ा कांग्रेस के लिए एक वरदान जैसा साबित हुआ कि हम विजय की ओर बढ़ रहे थे, इससे और ताकत मिलेगी, बहुत मजबूती मिलेगी और थम्पिंग मेजोरिटी, भारी बहुमत से हम 60 पार करेंगे, ऐसा मेरा मानना है। कांग्रेस में जो जोश खरोश आया तो ये एक बहुत बड़ा डिसीजन, बहुत बड़ा निर्णय और बीजेपी के लिए सेटबैक है, धोखा देकर छल कपट से कर लोगों को नहीं रखा जा सकता, विचारधारा से लोग रहते हैं। यशपाल जी कांग्रेस ही विचारधारा रखते, कांग्रेस में आए, कांग्रेस में बड़े बड़े हुए, उनका उपयोग कांग्रेस करेगी, प्रदेश के विकास में उनका योगदान रहा और अधिक योगदान और जिम्मेदारी का निर्वहन करेंगे।
Party spokesperson Randeep Surjewala informed that Yashpal tendered his resignation from the post of cabinet minister today in the morning. Yashpal Arya served as the speaker of Uttarakhand Legislative Assembly from 2002 to 2007. He was then a member of Congress. He also served as the president of the Congress Uttarakhand unit from 2007 to 2014. He had joined the Bharatiya Janata Party in 2017 just ahead of the assembly polls in that year. Yashpal Arya represents the Mukteshwar Assembly constituency, while his son Sanjeev represents the Nainital seat. The State Minister for Health and Family Welfare and Medical Education, Dr. Sudhakar K, on Sunday said that there has been a paradigm shift in modern women's thinking as they do not want to get married and give birth to babies. Speaking at the program organized by NIMHANS or NIMHANS here on World Mental Health Day, the minister said he is sorry to say that lot of modern women in India want to stay single. Even if they get married, they don't want to give birth and they want surrogacy. So there is a paradigm shift in thinking which is not good, Sudhakar said. He further said that we are moving towards westernization. The people are going to the western way and they don't want their parents to live with them, said Sudhakar. In more national news, Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday launched Indian Space Association via video conferencing, saying that India is among the few countries which have end-to-end technology in the space sector. The Prime Minister also interacted with representatives of the space industry on the landmark occasion. India has been witnessing major reforms for the advancement of the space sector and space technology. The basis of reforms in 21st century India is based on the country's capabilities and abilities. India is one of the very few nations to have an end-to-end capability in space. Today, we are marching towards strengthening space exploration and efficiency and affordability, he said. He also further mentioned that in the last few years, his government's focus has not just been on research and development of new technologies, but also on ensuring its reach the common citizen.
आज जिस अप्रोच के साथ आगे बढ़ रहा है, जो रिफॉर्म्स कर रहा है, उसका आधार है भारत के सामर्थ्य पर अटूट विश्वास। भारत का सामर्थ्य दुनिया के सभी देश से जरा भी कम नहीं है। इस सामर्थ्य के आगे आने वाली हर रुकावट को दूर करना हमारी सरकार का दायित्व है और इसके लिए सरकार कोई कोर कसर बाकी नहीं छोड़ रही। आज जितनी निर्णायक सरकार भारत में है उतनी पहले कभी नहीं रही। स्पेस सेक्टर और स्पेस टेक को लेकर आज भारत
The India-China Senior Military Commanders Marathon Dialogue on Sunday did not yield any result, with the Chinese Army not willing to address de-escalation in the three remaining friction points of the line of actual control in East Ladakh. The remaining friction points are Hot Springs, Depsang Bulge and Charding Nula Junction. It appears from the statements issued by two armies that the Chinese PLA was not inclined to go beyond the de-escalation agreed in the 12th round of dialogue. The Chinese statement is sanctimonious and asks India to cherish the past resolutions. Instead of misjudging the situation, the Indian side should cherish the hard-won situation in China-India border areas. Senior Colonel Long Shaohua, spokesperson for the Western Theatre Command of the People's Liberation Army, said in a statement on Monday, The Indian side pointed out during the talks that the situation along the LAC had been caused by unilateral attempts of Chinese side to alter the status quo and in violation of the bilateral agreements. It is therefore necessary that the Chinese side take appropriate steps in the remaining areas so as to restore peace and tranquility along the LAC in the western sector, India further said. That's all for News Pulse. I'm Esther. Keep watching Hornbill TV.